Good morning, guys. Thanks for listening to Coffee with Christ. If you haven't subscribed, hit the button below. If you like this, hit the like button. You know, share these with your friends. So it's a good day. I took yesterday off for the holiday and like so many just celebrating Martin Luther King Jr. And I loved looking through at like the quotes from him because the man has some amazing quotes. Just, I mean, I will say, I love quotes. I love words anyway. And so I totally enjoyed looking through. That's a side note. And another side note this morning, I was totally blessed Sunday by maybe one of my youngest listeners. Her name is Julia, and I just wanted to take a minute and tell her hello and that God has amazing things planned in her life for her, that she is going to do things far greater than she could ever imagine because Jesus loves her so much and her heart is for him. So I love that. Hello, thanks for listening. And we're going to jump right in pretty quickly today. We're going to be out of Acts 8 and we're talking about great persecution coming to Jerusalem. So it says in Acts 8 that a great wave of persecution came, right? And isn't that kind of everyone's fear, you know, at times that we're going to be persecuted? Because if we live here in the United States, we're rarely persecuted for our faith like they were. I mean, you may be, somebody might not want to be your friend or something like that, but rarely are we're under severe persecution. And this was severe persecution against the church. Like, Paul come in and was dragging them out of their houses, it says, and going from house to house, and Stephen had been murdered, and this was great persecution, like death. And it says that the believers were scattered. And so the question is, you know, did God cause this? Because these were his people. These were people full of the Holy Spirit doing his work. So did God cause this? Why didn't God protect them? Well, the answer is emphatically no, God did not cause this. God does not cause persecution. He is not pleased by it. He is not happy by it. He does not want humanity to suffer, believers or unbelievers. He doesn't. It was never his original design when we first open up and read Genesis. He made the world good and wanted it like that, but we live in a fallen world. When the Satan was allowed to come in, the devil, and angels fell and darkness came, you know, we live in a fallen world. And so that's why it's really important to just be reminded that it's Jesus that gives life abundantly. We know that. Jesus is the perfect expression of God and he gives life abundantly. God does not cause this stuff. Every good and perfect gift is from above. So we live in this fallen world. The enemy, Jesus said, comes to steal, kill, and destroy. So the enemy, the Satan, was at work and great persecution came. So what did God do about this? So great persecution still comes. You know, it still comes to believers all over the world and could potentially come more and more here in the United States. But the promise, the good news is God always, 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 always turns the bad in your life for good. What the enemy thinks that he's winning and has the upper hand, you know, he doesn't realize that God turns it for good. So what he thought he was stifling and snuffing out the church by this great persecution in Jerusalem, what happened really was then it made them, in verse 4, it says they were scattered and they went all over preaching the good news. So God's original plan was then actually fulfilled because they were afraid and they had to scatter all over. And the world was able to hear about Jesus in a time that there was no internet. And so they were able to go. And that is exactly what God does in believers' lives. You know, still today, he is able to take the pain, the loss, the fear, the feeling, the times that you've had to be displaced and turn that for good. We don't have to try to figure out how. I mean, Just receive it by faith. He did it for them. He did it on a large scale. He will do it for you. He will do it for you. If he's done it in the past, he will do it again. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We see this, the same principle in Joseph's life in Genesis 50:20. We see it here in New Testament, and it is still in operation today. That is good news. Receive it by faith, because God, whatever's going on, whatever's on your heart, he is going to turn that bad and work it for good. I believe it, and I'm praying it over you, and I will talk to you tomorrow, and have a great day.